Hello and welcome to this painting video. In this video, we're going to show you how to easily achieve the white and black scheme of the Frozen Stars Masque found in the Harlequins Codex. In order to do this, we're going to need to undercoat the model, and in this instance, we've used Grey Sear. What this does is easily allow us to go into the first half of the scheme, which is achieving the white, and we'll be doing this using Apothecary White mixed in with Contrast Medium. So what I'm going to look to do is get about 4 to 5 dollops of contrast medium and putting that on my palette. So just one more, cleaning off the brush, then getting a dollop of Apothecary White, mixing that in. Don't worry about getting the paint all over the model because you could be painting over quite a few of the areas. So with the Apothecary White now complete, the next thing to do will be to add Grey Sear. And in this instance, we're going to use Grey Sear just to tidy up some areas, as well as act as a natural highlight. Following that, we're going to use Ulthuan Grey as a spot highlight on the uppermost edges, and this will help to add some definition to the white. So the first thing I'm going to need to do is get some Grey Sear and just put it on my palette. And then I'm getting some water and thinning it down to a nice consistency. Washing off the brush and then making sure I get a nice sharp point on my brush. And I'm going to be applying this to the model's left leg, right arm and right hand side of the chest, left shoulder pad and left glove. So with that stage now complete, the next thing to do will be to highlight the model. And for this, we'll be using Ulthuan Grey and picking out all the areas where we've layered up with Grey Sear. With that stage complete, the white is fully highlighted. Don't worry about it looking very subtle, because once we've done the black areas, it will really start to pop. When doing the black, we're going to be using Corvus Black, and we're going to be applying this to the opposite areas of the model where we've done the white. So I'm going to take some Corvus Black and apply it onto my palette, thin it down with some water, get my brush to a nice neat point, and then applying the black onto the opposite areas of where we've highlighted the white to tie into that Frozen Stars quartered scheme. In this instance, I'm also using a medium layer brush because I want to be quite neat with how I'm applying the black. So with the black now applied, the quartered scheme is starting to take shape. Don't forget to paint the back of the head as well. The next thing to do will be to apply Abaddon Black. And what we're going to do is use this as a shade, so we're going to need to wash it down quite a lot. After that, we're going to use Dawnstone and use it as an edge highlight. So as you can see here, just getting some Abaddon Black onto my palette, getting quite a bit of water and washing it down so we get it to be a nice thin consistency. That looks about right to me. Just get the excess off on the brush, get the brush to a nice sharp point. And what we're looking to do is just to get it into the recesses of the model. So just behind the leg over here and wash it in. Don't be afraid about getting it over the top like what I've done over here, all right? Because you can just go over that again with Corvus Black. So with the black now shaded, the final bit to do will be to apply Dawnstone as an edge highlight. And I'm just going around the model, applying it to the raised areas. And there we are. With that highlight now finished, the black and white scheme with the Frozen Stars is complete. By following any of these methods, you can easily transfer these skills to any models in your own collection. We hope you've enjoyed this painting video, and we hope you enjoy painting your own Frozen Stars. And we look forward to seeing you in the next video. Goodbye!